Okay, let's start up again. Since my boyfriend came home and I had to take a break, so let's start again. So we were at the last row with the threes. So one, two, three, and into the last one here. And then up in the next two. Tidy up a little bit. So that was the freeze. So now what we are going to do is we are taking one bead at a time now. So one white into the middle of the threes. One bead into the middle again. One bead into the middle of the threes. Again into the middle, one into the middle, one again and into the middle, one again. Last one into the middle of the three, and then we go in to the single one that we did at this row. Just need a little more line. Tied it up a little bit. And now we take one again, but then we have to take it in to the one that we did at that row. So in. Next one, and the next, oopsie, and the next one, oops. Again. Ow! Sorry, I just poked myself with the needle. I'm very good at that. One again. Last one into that one, and then we go into the one that we started with. There we go. Okay, then we take one bead, but now we have to go through two of the ones, so one, want to. One bead, go through two of the single ones, like this. One again, go through two beads. And one bead. And then we go up in this one, and then we take one and into the one, four times here in the end, and two. And four. The last one, let me see where it is. There it is. So that was the end of that. So now we just go around to close it up and make sure that we secure this fret so the beads won't pop up again. So we simply just secure the fret, and that you do just by going around in the beads. That's the only thing you do. Then you can see how the beads are going, so you just go up and down and wherever you want to go when you secure the fret. But yeah, you just simply out, go round and round and round. And when you do that, this with the thread around, it also does so it feel more sturdy. So, yep. So that was it. So now we just cut off this thread. There we go. So now we have the pacifier here. So now we just put that to side. And then we will start on the ring. Yep. Just just put the needle on it, so just give me a second, I will just pause. Okay, then let's start on the ring. So we have a new thread, and then we take 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 beads of the pink one, as using the pink ones, and you can also, you can use whatever color you want to. There are no rules on what color you want. But yeah, of course, many times if it's a girl you have, then you probably are going to make some pacifiers in girl colors, and if it's boy, in boy colors. So now we have 6 beads here in the ring. So this is going to be a little bit difficult to start with because it's so little. So, but what you're doing is you take 1 bead. 1 bead. And then you jump over 1. Say this part is the hardest because you have to start on this. So let's see. I'm sorry. As I said, this is the most horrible thing to start with, but it gets easier when you have done some more rows. Then 1 more, skip, jump in, and into the first one, into the first one. Doing from now is just 1, 1, 1. So 1 again into that one. Into the next one. And then into the first one in the row that you started with. Always go into the first one that you start with. So when you finish with 3 beads around here, then always go through the one that you started with. But as I said, the beginning here is always a little bit difficult. 1, this one. And into the first one. Tidy up a little bit. But this is just what you keep doing until you think you have enough beads around to make a ring that you think that is big enough, and you decide how long you want to make them. So that's all up to you.